Hello and welcome to this Zero Security training video on business logic flaws. Business logic flaws are some of the most difficult issues to find because they don't follow any special pattern. They are going to depend on the logic of the web application that we are looking at. In the application that we are going to look at, we have three users: admin, Eve, and Joe. Admin belongs to user group admin, which is group 0. Eve and Joe belong to group 1, which is limited users. Admin users require a PIN to log in, while limited users do not. This is interesting for business flaws because it's a typical case when authentication is going to be slightly different for admin users than other users, so there's potential for human error. Let's have a look at this web application and see what it does. If I log in as admin, we are greeted by the home page of the administrator. So we have this message: welcome to the administrator page, admin. And we have three options: log out, view turbines, and run commands. Run commands is a feature of this website which allows the administrator user to run any command that he wants on the website. View turbines is a page that allows to search the turbines in the database. In this page, it's very important to note in this application that admin users have two more fields. They have the owner field and the group field available. These fields allow to show turbines for other users. For example, I can type here Eve and view the turbines for Eve, Joe and view the turbines for Joe, as well as by group. So if I type group 1, then I see the turbines for both Eve and Joe, and if I type group 0, then I see the turbines for user admin. Finally, if there's no criteria for the search and we just click on the search button, we see all the turbines available. This is because I am an admin user, and admin users can view the turbines for all users. Turbines have a special field called secret code. This is a special code that should only be available to the appropriate users. In the case of admin, admin is able to view the secret code for all turbines. However, Eve and Joe should only be able to view the secret code of their own turbines. If I log out and then log in as Eve, you will see here that there's less options. So we have welcome to the user page Eve, so this is not the administrator homepage, and we have two options: we can log out or we can view turbines. If I click on view turbines, I don't have the owner and the group fields that administrators have, and if I click on search, I'm only able to view the turbines for Eve because I'm logged in as Eve. In a similar fashion to Eve, if I log in as Joe, I'm greeted by the homepage of limited users, which says welcome to the user page Joe, and then I can log out or I can view turbines. If I click on view turbines, I don't have the owner and the group fields that administrators have, and if I click on search, I can only view the turbines for Joe. So that is all the functionality on this website, so it is quite basic. So let's start to see what the problems are now. So the first issue is a business flaw on the login page. So it is possible to log in without a user, without a password, and without a PIN. And the way to check this is very simple in the web application. If we just click on the login button, then we are greeted by the administrator page, so we can run commands. Now, some interesting commands that you can run here for attacking purposes is that you can view the source code of the page. When you do this, it's important to do HTML entities after doing file get contents, because otherwise you are going to get the HTML of the page interpreted by the website. So this is why we have HTML entities in there, so that we can see the source code as it is on the file. So this is the first issue. An authentication bypass without a login. So now what we are going to do is we are going to go to login.php, which is where this problem is, and we are going to fix it. Okay, so first let's look at the problem. To look at the problem, we are going to uncomment those lines, and I'm going to log out. And now from here, if I log in first as Joe, for example, then we will see what a normal query looks like. So this is an XPath query that is checking if the user is Joe and the password is Joe's password. And then the result is an array. So this is calling an XPath function that usually returns an array of results. So count in PHP is a function that is meant only to be used with arrays. So when you pass it an array that has one element like this, it's going to return 1, which also evaluates to true in PHP. Now if we look at the source, this is what the code is doing. If count returns 1, this if evaluates to true and the user is being logged in. If we go back to the login and we blank all the details and then click on login, then we will see that what's happening is that an invalid query is being built. The result of the query is the boolean false, and then a count of the boolean false also returns 1. So this is a business logic flaw on the login function, because count of false returns true and the user is being logged in. So to fix this, instead of fixing it here, what we are going to do is we are going to fix it on a separate page so that we can compare later. So what we are doing here is we are creating a directory of fixed. Then we are CDing into that, and now we are copying the PHP files from the vulnerable version of the website into the local directory. The files include PHP files and XML files. Now the fix is essentially, before we are doing just a count without knowing if result is an array or not, so the fix is to add an isArray check before the count. So if we do that and we comment this, this is what the fix looks like. We are simply adding an isArray, and that should fix that business flaw. So if I save this, and now in here we are going to be working on the fixed version of the site. Okay, so now if I click on login, we are getting invalid login, please try again, as opposed to before. I have to comment this again. as opposed to before, that we were greeted by the admin page. So this is after the fix, and this is before the fix. So we fixed the first problem. Now what we can do is we can check if the logging of normal users is still working. So we can try that with if, for example, and we see that things appear to be working correctly. So we have fixed that problem. Now the next problem is that we can log in just providing a valid username. So we can log in, for example, as admin, and then we are greeted as admin, and we can run commands. We can log in as if, and we can log in as Joe. So this is another business flaw that is allowing users to log in without a password. So to see what's happening, we are going to uncomment these lines again. Let's see what query is being built by the application. So if I try to log in as Joe, we will see that the application is building an XPath query that is only checking if the user is Joe, but is not checking if the password is right. So what's happening is, when the XPath query is being run, it returns a match, so count returns 1, and the user is logged in. So the problem in this case is located on the following section of the code. This is checking if the post variable is being set and if the length is greater than 0. Now this is useful in this application because we have admin users who require a pin and normal users who don't require a pin. So this is the solution that has the business flaw, just to allow for that to happen. So what we need to do now for the fix is to leverage the fact that both admins and limited users require a user and a password. So we can change that code so that it only loops on the user and the password, and then it doesn't check the length. So let's implement that fix. So this is the fix, and this is what it was before. Now the other thing that we need to do is we need to check the pin if the user is an admin user, but we only know if the user is a valid admin user after the XPath query. So that check for the pin needs to be here, cannot be there, needs to be here, so that we know if the group of the first result, which is in the index 0, in the array returned by simple XML, which is the library we are using, if the group is not 0, then this is a limited user and does not require a pin. But if the pin, if the group is 0, then it's an admin. So in such a case, then the pin should match the pin that is provided by post. So that is that fix. Now if we try to log in as Joe, as admin, or as if, again without the password, this does no longer work, because we fixed that problem. Okay, we are not checking the length anymore, we are always checking all the variables that are being passed. So that was the problem with the str length, and then the indepin, we are checking it with the results from simple XML from running the XPath query. Now the next issue that we need to fix is that it is still possible to log in without a password as users Eve or Joe. But for this, we need to use Zap. So if I click on, if I enable a global breakpoint with Zap, and then I try to log in as Eve, and then I click on login, and then go here. Okay, we have user Eve, no password, no PIN, and what we need to do is delete the password and the PIN section. So if I delete that and I disable the breakpoint and click on play and then go back to the browser, I'm logged in as Eve. Similarly, I can log in as admin using the same approach. I set a global breakpoint on all incoming requests, and then if I click on login here, if I delete this and then disable the global breakpoint and hit play and then go back to the browser, then this is stopped because admin users require a PIN. So this only works for Joe and Eve. However, we can still log in as admin without a password and only with the PIN. So if I click on login and then go in here, I can remove the password and then disable the breakpoint, hit play, and now I'm admin, and I could log in just with a PIN and no password. So this is the same vulnerability. Okay, so that is with Zap, and then another way to do this is with Firebug. So if we click on Firebug, in here I can type if, and then on the password field I can just right click and click on delete element and then click on login, and that logs me in as if, because what's happening is the password element is being removed from the form, so when I submit the form the password field is not going to be there. So where is the problem here? The problem is on this isSet section. So the parameters supplied by the user and the password are only added to the query if they are passed in the POST request. So by removing it from the POST request, we can bypass this business logic flaw. So that is the vulnerable code, and now what we have to do is to remove this isSet check. So if we delete that, now this attack should no longer work. Okay, so this is after the fix. We don't have the isSet. So let's see if this works. I try to log in as Eve. I delete the password element. And then I click on login. And it doesn't work. If I try it with Joe, it's going to be the same thing. Right click, delete element, login, invalid login. So we fix this issue. Now, there's still more problems here, because the application is using cookies for logic on the privileges of the users. So for this, we can use Firebug as well. So if we click on cookies, and we can delete all these cookies, just to start fresh, delete that, delete this, and delete this. Okay, so now there are no cookies. And this is the login page. So the first vulnerability with cookies is a horizontal privilege escalation. So this means that one user can do the same as another user at the same level. This is why it's called horizontal privilege escalation. So let's say I log in with Joe. With the password for Joe. Okay, and now we have these cookies here. So the horizontal privilege escalation vulnerability requires to tamper with the user cookie. Okay, so if we change the user cookie, instead of being Joe, we change it to Eve. Without that new line character. Now if I reload the home page, I'm Eve. And if I go to view turbines, I can view the turbines for Eve. So that is the horizontal privilege escalation. Now another thing that we can do is we can do a vertical privilege escalation. So we can change the user group to 0, which is admin, and we can change the user to admin. Now if I refresh the home page, I'm admin and I can run commands on the server. I can as well view the turbines for all users as an admin. So we saw the horizontal and the privilege escalation vulnerabilities by tampering with the user cookie and the logged in cookie. So these are those two here. Horizontal privilege escalation, so user Joe can become Eve, and vertical privilege escalation because user Joe can become admin as well. Now there's another flaw which is more serious, which is that if we log out from here, pay attention to this logged in cookie, alright? So if I log out, this logged in set to 1. So I log out and now I'm going to delete all the cookies, and in here what we are going to do is we are going to create a new cookie that is going to be called logged in with a value of 1. Now if I go to the home page, I'm administrator without a login. Okay, I didn't type a username, a password, or a PIN. I only created a cookie with logged in set to 1, and that, when I navigate directly to home.php, makes me administrator. So I can run commands on the web server without being, without having a valid user. Okay? So how do we fix this? The problem is all these cookies are really being used for controlling privileges for different users, and that just cannot be on the client side, because if it is on the client side, you just saw how easy it is for anybody with Firebug or any other tool to just change the cookies. So we need to move all this code from the cookie global array in PHP into the session. So if I do grep cookie, we have to replace all this with session. So let's start doing that. I go to home, and we need to do session start, and we need to change this to session. We can search for cookie as well, so that we get all the all the cookies changed to session. So we're doing session start, and then all the checks that we had before with cookies, we have changed them so that they work with the session. Okay, so that is home.php fixed, and now we need to change as well view turbines, which is another file where we got a match. So I can right click here, copy. Okay, so in here, which is the session. And there are no more cookies. So that is the first part of the search. So we searched for cookie, and that returned home and view turbines has been affected by this, and they were changed. And now the other thing that we have to check is we have to grep for cookies that are being set. Okay, so we grep for set cookie, and that gives us a match on the login.php page. So let's check. I forgot the session start on view turbines, so we can add that now. Now another thing is on the login.php file, we need to, which is where cookies are being set, we need to do the session start at the top, but then here, now we need to change the logged in part here to a cookie, from a cookie to the session, and we need to change the group. The group and the user, which were previously on cookies, we are moving them from cookies into the session. So we can delete those, and then we need to cast to string, because otherwise simple XML is going to throw exception of converting a simple XML element into a string. But we really only care about the string, so we can cast it like this and it's fine. Okay, so that is it. So we have fixed the home page, we have fixed the login, we have fixed view turbines, and now if we delete all the cookies, history, and clear everything. So now we've deleted all the cookies, and now if we try to log in using, for example, if you will notice that we only have a PHP session ID, we no longer have the user logged in and the group as inputs, so we can no longer change them. Okay, so that fixes the problem of cookie tampering simply by not having cookies that the user can mess with. So the bottom line here is that you should always favor session over cookie whenever possible. Now, there's another business flaw in the logout functionality. Because, for example, now I'm logged in as Eve. If I click on logout and now I click the back button, I'm still logged in as Eve. Now, this could be a greater concern if instead of logging as Eve, I log in as admin. Let's imagine that admin, Joe, and Eve are all on the same office. And then, for some reason, admin doesn't lock his computer, and Eve, who is sitting beside him, decides to, when the user, I'm user admin now, and then I click on log out, and then Eve takes advantage that user admin didn't lock out his computer, and she can click on the back button and then run any commands. She is essentially admin. She can as well view the turbines for other users, including admin and Joe, which she shouldn't see. So this is another business flaw, which is that the logout functionality is not working. It hasn't been implemented. So to fix this, we need to go into the login.php file, and in here we need to add the following lines. So we delete everything in the session, and then sessions regenerate ID is going to change the ID of the session, and is going to delete the session file from disk as well, the previous session. So this ensures that every time the login page is being loaded, the session for the user is being wiped. So if I save this, now we can try to exploit the logout functionality. So if I log in as admin, the logout functionality should now be working. Okay, so I'm admin, I type the password and the PIN, I click on login, and now I click on logout, and if I click the back button, then I'm no longer able to see the home page. So it is not possible to impersonate the admin user now clicking the back button as we were doing before. So we fixed this vulnerability. Now, another problem, of course, is that we can read the XML files directly. So from there, we can just, on the URL of the application, if we type turbines.xml, then we can view all the secrets without having a login. And of course, we can as well view the users and their credentials. So with this, we can log in. So before, we were loading it from a file, but now we are loading it from HTTP. Okay, so now we can log in as admin just using the information in the XML file, which can be retrieved without authentication. Just anybody browsing to this URL can read it. Okay, so now we can run commands and these are some commands that we could run. For example, so we can retrieve the source code of the login page of run command. So any of the files that the web application has, we can see the source code without having a login. Just because of the ability that the website provides to run commands, and the bypass because of the authentication bypass because of having all the users exposed in an XML file. Okay, so to fix this, we need to move the XML files away from the web root. So to do that, first we can create a directory called home www business logic lab one fixed. Okay, and from there what we are going to do is we are going to move the XML files from the fixed version of the site into this path. Now another thing that we want to do is to lock down permissions. So we are making this only readable and writable to the owner. And then we are going to make the Apache user, which is www-data, the owner of this directory so that Apache can write into it, can read from it. Now, if we do this, we can see the files in there, which belong to the Apache user, so the Apache user should be able to read them. Now, what we need to do, so this is the first step, was to prepare a directory to move the XML files, and now we need to see in which files in the source code the XML files are being referenced. So we see that login.php is using this, and we need to add this path where we are moving the files. We need to add it in there. So we just go to login.php, and then in there we just add that path. And the other grep that we need to do is for turbines.xml, and that gives us only this match. So we can copy this and edit it. And in there we will need to put this path as well, which is the path of the XML files. So if we search for simple XML, in there we can just paste this. Now the XML files are no longer in the directory. They are in another directory that cannot be retrieved from the URL. So now if we refresh this, this file is not found. And similarly, turbines.xml is not found. So this attack does no longer work. However, the application should still be working. So if I try to log in as if, I should be able to log in, which means the user's XML file can be used by the application. So that worked. And now if I search turbines and I'm getting results, this means that the XML file for the turbines is being loaded right as well. So the fix is working and we did not break functionality. So we verified the fix that those files are not found, we logged in again and we could search turbine. So all that is working. So that issue is fixed. Now what we need to do is we need to fix or demonstrate another security issue. Okay, so in this case, the problem is that the application, so for example, if I go to the home page, for example, like this, it seems to take me back to the login. Okay, so it seems that authentication is working. However, if we prepare that in there and we set breakpoint, and now what we want the breakpoint on is on the response, not on the request. Okay, so now if I go to the home like this in Zap, I can change this to an OK, and we are going to see the administrator page. Look at this. This is the HTML for the home page of the administrator. Okay. So let's change this to an HTTP 1.1 OK. And the location header, if we delete it, then the browser is not going to follow it, so it's going to show us the home page. So now I've disabled the global breakpoint and I click on play, and now in the browser we are still admin. Okay, so going to home without a login and a password can be bypassed. Okay, let's do that again. So I click on home and we get found, but we are really getting the admin page. So just change the HTTP response to 200 and delete the location header, which is this, and then we remove the breakpoint, we click on play, and in here we are admin. Okay, so we have an authentication bypass that, because of the design of the application, results in remote code execution. So we saw that, and now what we are going to do is to fix it. So we need to search all the code that is using headers. Okay, so if we grep for header, we will see all the code that is sending headers to the browser, because that's where the problem is. The problem is the headers are being sent, however the script continues running. So this is saying header location logging, but then it is showing all the administrator page. So this is another business logic flaw. And to fix this, what we need to do is we need to add an exit so that this stops. Okay? So that is that header. There are no more headers on this file. And the other file with headers is logging. So in there we should exit as well. So anytime you send a location header, you should exit. In a real application, you would probably wrap this in a go to page function or something like that, but this is just for demonstration purposes. So, and the other file is index.php. There is no more code after the header, but we can add the exit in there just to remind anybody changing that file in the future that that should exit. So now if we try the attack again, we set a global breakpoint on the response and I put here home.php and I go to zap. Now we see that we get the found, but we are no longer getting the home page. So that business flaw is being fixed as well. So now if I remove the location and I disable the breakpoint and I click play, I'm going to get a blank page because there's no home page being displayed. The next problem is that we can still see turbines if we access the URL directly. So we are logged out at the moment. Okay, so if I go to here, we are logged out. And now if we browse to view turbines, in here there is no authentication. So I can view all the turbines and all the secrets without a login. Okay, so the home page kicks me out to the login page, but the view turbines page does not. So I can use this page directly and view all the turbines with all the secrets. In addition to this, another thing I can do is I can go to run command directly, which does not verify authentication either, and then I can run arbitrary commands on the website without having a valid login because of a direct reference to a PHP file that is not enforcing authentication. Okay, so that is how that looks like. This is the remote command execution vulnerability because of the authentication bypass. And yes, what something that I wanted to show you here is that we could retrieve the login, then from the login we can see the location of the user's XML file, so we can retrieve it from there, and then we can see all the users and passwords and pins in that XML file. So this issue is quite a serious bypass. So to fix this, we need to create a central controller. Okay, so a bad way to fix it would be to add authentication code on each file, but then you forget one file and an attacker can get you that way. So what we need to do is to centralize all the authentication code in a single place. So the first step for that is to build a map of the pages that we have. So this command is doing an ls of the directory, then we are translating new line characters by blank spaces, and then set is replacing the blank spaces with a comma and a quote before and after that. Then we're changing the start to an array and a parenthesis and a single quote, and then we're changing the end of the line. We are removing the trailing comma and a quote, and then we are adding a closing parenthesis and a semicolon. So this is what the output looks like. So we're getting an array of the pages that we have. This is just a shell one-liner trick to save a little bit of time to build a map. Okay, and now what we want to do is we want to move all the PHP files outside from this directory into our previous directory where we saved the XML files. So this is going to reduce the attack surface of the application so that all the access to all the files is going to be controlled from a front controller. Now another thing that we are doing now is we are moving the index.php file back because we need this one here so that we don't have directory indexing. And now what we have to do is to create an HTML access, an htaccess file that is going to redirect all the requests using Apache's mod rewrite. It's going to route all the requests. If the file doesn't exist and the directory doesn't exist, then it's going to redirect the request to a PHP file that we are going to create, our front controller, that we are going to call dispatcher. Okay, dispatcher is another fancy name that some people use to call front controllers. But it's essentially a central file through which all the access will go. Okay, so now we have the htaccess file, and now we can create our dispatcher. Now this is our dispatcher file, and this is starting the session, and then is specifying where the directory for the source code is. Then from the URL it is getting the file name. And then we are creating here a whitelist of allowed file names, which are home, run command, and view turbines, which are the authenticated pages. Then the next line is checking if the user is not logged in, or the file is login.php, or the file is not in the whitelist, so not in array. Then we are going to show the login.php file. Okay, and if we are here, then this means that the file is one of these three files that we allowed, and then the user is logged in. So we load the file from the source directory. So as you can see, implementing a front controller does not need to have to be very difficult. Okay, so in a few lines you can put it together, and with mod rewrite, the advantage and the reason why we are using mod rewrite is so that the URLs look exactly the same as they looked before. So we are not breaking functionality and we are not changing the URLs as well. Okay, so that is our dispatcher. And now what we need to do is to enable mod rewrite, which I have already done, but that is how it looks like. This is a symbolic link from the modules available into the modules enabled. Okay, then you would restart Apache. And then another thing to check is that you have htaccess files enabled. And that is this allow override set to all on the var www directory. Okay, so just to check that that's done. Now, the cleanup is optional, but I would encourage you to do it. So let's do it, because otherwise, I mean, the application still works, but you get some warnings and it's just not very clean. So the thing is, all these session start lines are no longer necessary, because they are going to be, session start is going to be done by the dispatcher. So we don't need all this code in there anymore. So in fact, we don't need this or this. So that is the first fix. So in home.php, instead of all those lines, we just remove all that session stuff from there. Okay, so all that is gone, because we don't need it. The dispatcher is going to start the session and is going to kick the user out if they have not logged in. So this simplifies the code quite a lot. Like, otherwise you need something like this in all the files, or to remember to include a file that does this from all the files, and it becomes very messy and error prone. So with this approach, we just remove all the code from the individual files and we have a clean solution on the front controller. Now on login.php, after the fix, we just need to remove session start. So that's all on login.php, and then the other file is view turbines, and from here session start required PHP tag, so we can remove all that, and that is it. So now if we go to view turbines, well, first, okay, we are logged out. Now if we go to view turbines, this redirects us to the login page. If we go to run command, redirects us to the login page as well. So we fix the problem of direct access to PHP files just using this dispatcher approach. So the dispatcher keeps authentication simple. Okay, so that is the directory where the dispatcher is. Okay, and now we only have dispatcher and PHP. Now we have two files to attack, and before we had a lot more. And the dispatcher is centralizing all the authentication code in one place. Now, another thing we have to do is to check that functionality is still working. So we try to log in as if. We can log in as if, we can view the turbines. Everything seems to be working as it should. Okay. Great. Attacking authentication of individual PHP files will no longer work. This approach is very powerful to have a front controller. It's highly, highly recommended. Now, another problem we still have is that a user can log in. Okay, so we fixed the global the authentication problem in that you need to be logged in to access files, but the thing is, some of the files should not be accessible to some users. So the problem is, if we log in as if, and then we browse to run command, we are still able to run commands as an administrator because the code is checking just if the user is authenticated. Okay, so you need a login for this, but a limited user should not be able to use a page that should only be available to admin users. Okay, there's no run command here, but we can run command from here. And then from there, if could do HTML entities file get contents of dispatcher, and then she can see the location and the files. And from there, she can view the login source code. And from there, she can see the user's XML file location and see the credentials for all the users. So that is not good. So let's try. Yes, and another thing that if can do from here is to read the turbines, and this can all be guessed by looking at the source code. So it's quite trivial to do. And yes, she could also do an ls at the beginning if she has no knowledge, and then she can look at the dispatcher and all that. So okay, so how do we fix this? So we need to go to the dispatcher, and in there what we need to do is to improve our file map so that it checks it enforces the user groups. So we have, before we have three files that require authentication, so home.php, runcommand.php, viewTurbines. Now we have the same three files, but we have an array of maybe it is a little bit easier to see like this. Now we have an array of the groups that should be able to view each page. Okay, so we can put it like this. Okay, so three pages, exactly the same as before, and then home.php can be viewed by group 0, admin, and group 1, limited user. Run command can be viewed by group 0, admin. View turbines can be viewed by group 0, which is admin, or group 1, limited user. But the important thing is here, run command can only be viewed by admin users. Then, because we have changed the array from this to this, this means that we have to change the code in here slightly so that we do array keys. So this is a PHP function that is going to return an array as we had before. An array like this from this. Okay, because the first stage is to see if the user is authenticated or not, or if the page can be accessed or not. So for that stage, this array is still useful, and we can build this array from this array just using array keys. So that is what that is doing. And so now we can delete this, we can delete this, and let's see. So we have this, we have changed this, and then in here, what we need to do is to, so this is checking if the file can be reached and all that, and then in here is when the user is logged in, the file can be accessed, and then the additional check that we are adding is that the user is allowed for that page. So this map gives us which are the groups allowed for each page. So from the map, we are querying the map, we're passing the file to it. So it's going to be home.php, run command, and from there we're getting the array of the groups that are allowed, and those will be saved in this variable, allowed user groups. Then what we are doing is, if the session group, which is initialized after login, is not in the allowed groups for that page, then we are going to kick the user out to the login page, which is going to destroy the session as well. And otherwise, so in here the user is allowed to view this page, then we are going to load it. Okay, so this is an additional check that we can do on top of that. And then if on phase 2, phase 3, or phase 4 of the application more pages need to be added, this is easy to maintain here in the array as well. Okay, so we can save this, and now we can try to log in as if to verify. We can log out. Now we can log in as if, and from here we can try to go to the run command URL directly as we did before, and that is kicking us out to the login page. So the fix is working. Now what we should do is we should check, for example, with Joe, we can check if things are still working. Okay, everything seems to be working correctly. So this security issue has been fixed as well. We have another issue. So the turbine secrets should only be available to the relevant user owner. Okay, so if I go as if, I try to log in here as if, and I click on view turbines, I click on search, I only view the turbines for if. Okay, but now if we set a breakpoint on all incoming requests in SAP and we click on search again, we can see the variables that are being passed to the query. So what we are going to do is we are going to delete the owner and the group so that we see all the turbines. So let's do that. I go in here, I delete the owner, I delete the group. Now I'm removing the breakpoint because we no longer require tampering now, and then I click on play. And if I go back to the browser, I can see all the turbines for admin, for Eve, and for Joe. Okay, so this is a serious concern in this application, because Eve should only be able to see her own turbines. There's another way to do this, and it's a lot easier actually with Firebug. So in here we can click on the inspect, so that we go to the section of the application that has the code, or is close to the code that we are interested in. And in here we can see the two hidden fields. One is for Eve, which is the owner, and the other is group, which has the value of 1. So the application is using these hidden fields to lock Eve down into the turbines that she can see. However, these hidden fields can be changed. So we can simply right click here and delete element, and right click here and delete element. And now when we click on search, those two input fields will not be part of the request. So we are doing the same as we did with Zap, but we can do it with Firebug as well. So now if I click on search, I view as well admin, Eve, and Joe. So I'm seeing all the turbines in the system by simply changing those hidden fields. So you can see how easy it is to change a hidden field in a form to then to bypass this form of client-side logic. Okay, so hidden fields and cookies should never be used for things like this, because they are very easy to tamper. So now that this vulnerability is demonstrated, it's time to fix it. So let's go to the home directory where we have moved the files before. Now if I go to view turbines, what we need to do is to first have a look at the existing code. So the first problem is that, you might see it better here with the syntax highlighting, the first problem is that the code is checking if the session group is not 0, then it's showing the hidden input fields. And if not, so this is for admin users, then it is displaying the fields. So this check is a business logic flaw, because this can be bypassed, right? It's not the proper way to enforce the permissions. And then the query in here is using isSet as well, the XPath query. So it's doing an isSet, and it's checking that the length of the post field is greater than 0. So we need to make sure that doesn't happen. So if the user is Eve, then the owner and the group should be those for Eve in the query itself. So to fix it, we can move this initialization of the XPath query, which at the moment was here. We can delete it from here, and in here we can initialize it before the if, so that it is always initialized. And then we delete the input fields by starting the XPath query instead. So now this is no longer on the client side, it is on the server side code, is where the query is being built. So now I can delete this. And then from there we just need to delete We just need to delete the initialization that we did already, so we are good to go. Because this is really, in the case of the Vue Turbines page, this is really not a concern. The important thing is to lock the users down into what they can see at the query level. So let's see how this works. And let's show the query as well, so that we understand what's happening. So now, what we need to do is to set up a global breakpoint, and we click on search. And in here, we try to delete the owner and the group. And then disable the breakpoint, click on play. And we get that the owner is Eve and the group is one. Even though we just deleted the owner and the group. So Eve still locked down into what she can see. Also, in here, there are no more hidden fields, so that cannot be changed. Another attack that you could try is to change the owner and the group and see what happens. Okay, so we set a global breakpoint and we click on search, and now in Zap, instead of that, we are going to use this. So we are going to add owner admin and group 0 and see if we can see the admin turbines. Okay, and what's happening is that the application doesn't return anything because it is joining all the criteria with an AND, so the user is always locked into being Eve and group 1. So this doesn't work. This attack of trying to view the turbines for admin and group 0 doesn't work. The same way that it wouldn't work to try to see the turbines for Joe. Now, at this point, we still have a privilege collation vulnerability on the login page. This privilege collation vulnerability can be exploited by changing a hidden field. And the reason why that attack works is because of this code snippet here. First, the group is taken from the post request and saved into a variable. And then only if the user group is 0, so that is administrator, then the variable is overwritten to 0. However, this allows a user that is not administrator to set group from post without any other restrictions. So the group is read from post, the user is not admin, so this doesn't happen, and then the group is saved in the session. You can see it with syntax highlighted here. So this is a very typical case of a business logic flaw because of initializing a variable and then having a flaw in the logic here, so that the end result is that unsanitized user input is saved into the session. So let's try to exploit this. So if I go in here and I try to log in as Eve, but before I hit the login button, I can use Firebug and the inspect icon to get close to this to the section of the page where the hidden fields are. And in here, we will notice that there is a hidden group field with a value of 1. So if we change that to 0, and then click on login, we are administrator, so we can run commands. So this is a very very common business flaw when you assign variables and then don't have a flaw in the logic afterwards that doesn't change the variable back. So it is very important to always initialize variables to something that doesn't give any rights to the user, so that if there's a mistake in the logic, at least you don't have this problem. We can see here that if can see the admin turbine secrets and Joe turbine secrets. So that is this vulnerability. Okay, so how do we fix this? There are two things that we can do to fix it. One thing is to hide, well, to remove the hidden field, and then just, this is the most important thing to do, what we want to do is to take, instead of taking the group from post, we want to take it directly from the database. So how do we do this? Well, the fix is relatively simple. So instead of having all of this, we just delete, or we can comment this, if you prefer that. We can comment that section, and then instead of using dollar group, we are going to use user group, which is the group that was loaded from the database. And then because of simple XML, because this is a simple XML element, we have to cast this into an integer. So that should solve the problem. So let's do this before we remove the hidden field. The hidden field is still here, so that we can test with Firebug. Okay, so now if I try to log in as if, well, first, no, that's fine. If I try to log in as if, and then in here on the hidden field I set this to 0, and I click on login, now I am no longer admin because the source code is no longer using post to take the group. Okay, so this was the problem. So we can delete this. That is that fixed. And then, of course, we don't need this hidden field. So if I log out and now I do this, there's no longer a hidden field. Another thing you can do is to try to set a global breakpoint in Zap to try if you can log in as if, and then when the request is captured, we can try to add the group in here. Set the group to 0, and then disable the breakpoint and hit play, and see what happens. We are still a limited user, so the fix is working. Even if the hidden field is removed and we change the post request to contain the group is no longer used by the code. So we fixed this business logic flaw just in this line. And this concludes this lesson on business logic flaws. Thank you for joining us.